So announcing today the newest version of Mapping Tonal Harmony Pro, version 9. And what's truly amazing and very unique about this new version is our new analyzer feature, allowing you to arrange and write songs outside of the map, as well as opening other music XML files from apps like iReel.
If you're new to MDEX Music, we create music books and apps, piano arrangements, and we discuss improvisation, songwriting, and sometimes we take music theory to strange and uncharted places. So subscribe and hit the bell and join us for exclusive access to our ever-expanding library of music resources. Okay, so let me show you how to enter in your own chord progression. You'll see this new button up here, the Editor Analyzer button, and that's exactly what we're going to use to do all of this. So let's look at our editing screen here. You can see down at the bottom, there's a small tutorial about how this works, how to do the bars, how to label your sections, how to account for the beats, and all that stuff. But let me just show you in real time how I might do this. So let's go, D minor 7. And as it says at the bottom, I could account for the other three beats of this measure by going space, hyphen, space, hyphen, space, hyphen. And then my bar line, or I could just put the chord symbol if I want it to last the entire measure, I can just go to the bar line right after that, just like that. So two different ways of doing that. Let's do D minor 7 again, and then we'll go back to G7 bar line. I'll press enter for a system break, and then let's do E minor 7 for a whole bar, A7 for an entire measure, and let's do that again, E minor 7 to A7 bar line. Enter, system break, and let's do this one more line. D minor 7 for an entire measure, D flat 7 for an entire measure, and then C major 7 for an entire measure. Now I could do that, MAJ 7, or I could put in a little triangle here, shift on the 6th key there for the same exact chord symbol, bar line. And then how about just a little turnaround here at the end, two chords in this measure here, D minor 7, G7, space, hyphen, and then my bar line. All right, so now we can click on the Analyze button to see what mapping will do with this. But before I do that, let me make sure I have the right genre accounted for here. This is going to inform which map we're using, some of the chord scale pairing, some of the chords available to us, and how the play-along is going to treat the music. We're just going to stay in jazz standards here, but you can see there's all these other options related to all these other genres of music, depending on what you're trying to write or arrange. Jazz standard, analyze, and away we go. Look at that. So right off the bat, you can see we have some great analysis here, some great chord scale pairings, our brackets and arrows analysis. Start off with a 2-5 in G. And then a 2 of 2, some secondary dominants over here. And mapping picked up on this perfectly. And then at the end, a sub-5. And I got our 2-5 turnaround at the end. And I can change this and put this in whatever key I want over here. Let's put it in, I don't know, E-flat. Let's do that. Boom. And now it's completely transposed into really, well, any key that I want. Let's hear what it sounds like in our original key with the play-along. So there's our user-generated chord progression. What if I want to open a music XML file from another program or another app, something like iReel? Well, let me show you how to do that. We're going to click on the editor again, and then right here you see the Open Music XML button. I already have a bunch of files that I've imported from iReel right here. Let's do a Fine Romance. And so it's going to automatically import it, load it into the map, and do a functional analysis and do all the chord scale pairings, the cadence detection, the arrows and brackets analysis is all here. Not only that, we have access to all the amazing play-along features and the customizability there within that's built into Mapping Tonal Harmony Pro. You can click on any chord, hear how it sounds, get to this right here, So this D minor 6 has always bothered me as it relates to using iReal. So let's change it. Let's go back to the editor analysis. You can see the chord scale pairing is good and the two chord analysis is correct, but let's see what it might sound like if we, D minor 7, and then there's another one down here. I gotta grab, delete, boom. And let's change it out of this blues format into the jazz standard. Analyze again. And now if we click and play. Ah, way better. You can hear the voice leading is there. All right, well, let's click on the play button and see what happens.